There are so many tools in digital marketing that you may get confused. Here is my recommendation of top 10 tools that every digital marketer should use. Number 1 is Search Console. You want to talk to the search engine, so you get that interface through Search Console. Are there any crawl errors? Are there any indexing errors? Is your sitemap automatically getting updated? What are the search terms that people are actually organically searching, and what is the click-through rate for the organic search terms? You get all the data in Search Console. Number 2 tool that you can use is Keyword Planner. You want to find out that how many searches users are making in search engine, and what is the traffic that it is driving, how much is the competition, and how much is the bid that you have to place for each keyword. You get the data on Keyword Planner tool. You can use it for identifying the keywords that you want to optimize the site for. Another related tool is Suval. It gives you the keywords that people are searching on different platforms. So if you want to do optimization for YouTube, maybe the queries, they have more keywords in longer phrases like how to. You get what are the nature of queries that people are making on Google or making on Amazon or YouTube and so on. Third tool which I would recommend is Google Trends. It culls out trend based on organically what people are searching, and millions of searches happening across the web. It can really throw lights on whether the trend is upward or it is downward. You can also do competitive benchmarking. So does the competitor have more interest amongst the target audience? So more searches are happening for the competitor. Or is there any difference in the interest according to regions? What are the queries that people are using when they are searching on the search engine? Fourth tool to look out for is social mention. You want to find out whether there is any buzz at all about your brand, and you want to figure out the buzz in real time, in the last 24 hours. Social mention will tell how much is the reach, how much is the sentiment, positive or negative. Maybe a lot of people are talking about your brand, but there's a lot of negative sentiment. Then the objective for the brand is to convert negative sentiment into positive sentiment. What are the keywords that people are associating? What are the hashtags that people are associating with your company or your brand? Next tool I would recommend is Fan Page Karma. You want a good rounded analysis across all social media platforms, then this is the tool to go to. It will give you analysis of not just Facebook, but also LinkedIn, Instagram, YouTube, Pinterest, Snapchat, and so on. You want to find out, are people engaging with you and your brand? What is the engagement rate? This tool will tell you. You want to see how many views are there for your video, how many shares, how many retweets, and what is the frequency of your posting? What is your response rate? All these things you can compare with competition as well. Next tool I would recommend is Twitternomy. It is primarily used for Twitter. You want to do competitive benchmarking. How many followers you have vis-a-vis your competitors? What is the retweet rate? How much is the social influence or clout that you have on Twitter and other social media? You find all this from Twitternomy. Very interesting tool to understand the users who are following you is Follower Wonk. Lot of people may be following you, but then do they have social influence? You want to identify who are the bloggers, who are the thought leaders, who are the influencers in your field. You can identify them using follower wonk, and you can follow them, and you can directly tweet to them and build a rapport. Thereby, they can follow you back. A must tool to have is Google Analytics. It is for free, unless you want to go for a professional version. Google Analytics will tell you how many users converted, how many users led you to achieve your goals, what is the multi-channel funnel, what are the different channels that users interacted with before they finally made a purchase. It will also help you do an attribution. If you think last click is not the correct attribution model, you can do a linear attribution, which gives equal weightage to all channels of interaction. It also has a tool for heat map inbuilt. You want to find out where, which section of the website users are spending more time on, which buttons they are clicking. You understand all this from the heat map tool within Google Analytics. Last tool I would recommend is SEMrush. You want to find out and compare how many unique users came to your site vis-a-vis competition, how much time they are spending on the site, what is bounce rate, what is the stickiness, depth of engagement, what organic words people are searching, what are the traffic sources, are you having more pull or is it more online PR that is working for you, or maybe you are getting lot of traffic from email marketing campaign or display campaign. All this data comes very easily available through SEMrush. Please do like, share or subscribe to the YouTube channel, and also give your comments on some other tools that you may have discovered and you find worth mentioning. Also do visit my website profseema.com. Thanks for watching.